Today is Monday, March 29th, in the holy season of Lent. As we journey to the cross, prepare now to receive a message from God to you. Close your eyes and take slow, deep breaths. As you settle into the rhythm of your breathing, focus on God. If your mind wanders, bring it gently back. Allow a sense of peace and calm to surround you as you ready yourself to listen to God's healing word. Today's lesson is John 12:9-19. When the great crowd of the Jews learned that Jesus was there, they came not only because of Jesus, but also to see Lazarus, whom he had raised from the dead. So the chief priests planned to put Lazarus to death as well, since it was on account of him that many of the Jews were deserting and believing in Jesus. The next day, the great crowd that had come to the festival took branches of palm trees and went out to meet Jesus, shouting words from the Psalms, "Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord, the King of Israel." Jesus had found a young donkey and sat on it. It is written, "Do not be afraid, daughter of Zion. Look, your king is coming, sitting on a donkey's colt." This is a quote from Zechariah 9:9. John continues in verse 16, Jesus' disciples did not understand these things at first, but when Jesus was glorified, then they remembered that these things had been written of him and had been done to him. So the crowd that had been with him when he called Lazarus out of the tomb and raised him from the dead continued to testify. It was also because they heard that he had performed this sign that the crowd went to meet him. The Pharisees then said to one another, "You see, we can do nothing. Look, the world has gone after him." In this passage, everyone wanted to see Lazarus, the man who overcame death. They wanted to see him with their own eyes and hear the story from his lips. Little did they know that Jesus would shortly die, be raised from the dead, and ascend into heaven. Little did they know that they, as well as we today, have the promise of Jesus, of resurrection, and an eternal life with God. How does the promise of the resurrection change your life? How should we manage our fears about death? How can we celebrate the gift of each day that God gives us? Let us pray. Lord, in the week before your death, we see the fear of the disciples and your own anguish. We are also fearful of so many things in our lives. Help us to keep our faith and to focus on the coming resurrection. Thank you for the peace and the great joy that comes with your presence. Amen.